first of all, man, thank y'all for submitting all the questions, man. We greatly appreciate it. All of them. Yeah, because we had over like 50 questions, man. Yeah, so we kind of consolidated a lot of them. Let's get right on into it.
Does Stanley still have the brown Sheriff Mobley hat from Too Close to Home?
No, I no longer have the Sheriff Mobley hat. Yeah, because it was real cheap. I only paid $1 for it.
Lynette, how did you go from being an atheist to a believer?
Because I almost died. There's just some things that only God can do. And I should be dead, so I'm not. So now I believe.
What do you both do for a living?
I am a trader. And if anything knows about the stock market, yeah, I trade.
I'm an analyst. I analyze it. I make sure that no laws are broken. Make sure that the brokerage industry isn't getting over on the client. Making sure that the client ain't lying to the brokerage industry. I just analyze it.
Are you guys still doing reviews?
Yes, but we took a necessary break because I had a medical leave.
Yeah.
So it made no sense. And plus, it looks halfway sketchy that if I'm on medical leave, I'm always in front of the camera doing something. Because they'd be like, if you can do that, you can come to work.
Would you ever consider doing a video talking about your experience living in the trailer park?
Man, I would love to do them kind of video. Man, I just have to have the perfect opportunity to talk about that kind of skit. Because living in the trailer park was everything. I ain't gonna lie.
That's how you learn all your hustling skills, man.
Yes, sir.
How is your state handling what's going on now without outside influence?
Not very well.
Here's the example I want to use. It's like having a pissing section in a pool. Why aren't we shut down yet? But everybody else around us is shut down. But for real talk, they said, we would advise you. You can't advise Virginia people to do skit. You gotta
make them do it. But for the most part, a lot of stuff is shut down. Like all the entertainment stuff is shut down.
But not the people.
Yeah.
Them motherfuckers are at Walmart.
Are you guys ever thinking of relocating out of Virginia?
Yes! I think about relocating every day. The only thing that's keeping us in Virginia right now is, one, my mom. Stanley's mom, not so much, because he said that he's ready to just leave and come back and visit. But my mom, to uproot her, is not a wise decision for me.
How has life changed since Rona touched down?
Life is difficult.
It's everything is like sanitized every time you go home. Wear a mask when you go out. You so used to going out on Fridays and Saturdays, hang out at the lounge.
Yeah, your social life is gone.
Yeah, social life does not exist anymore. It makes you appreciate the social life that you had.
Mentally, it's a mind buck, y'all.
Who sold you your fake beard? My friend wants to purchase one.
This question came from Marcel. If y'all remember the show Love and Marriage Huntsville, Marcel, the one that got 26 women, that's what his mother-in-law said.
20 women?
That's the one asked me who I got my fake beard from. Marcel, I bought my beard from the Lord. How about that?
Lynette, have you always done your own hair and makeup because it always looks amazing?
Yes. I've always did it because I grew up poor. I learned it out of necessity. It's good for me.
When are we going to do a mukbang, Shan?
I ain't doing no mukbang with you.
I tell you, we're going to do a mukbang when they take calories out of food.
No, we're going to get together. We're going to do a seafood mukbang.
Yeah. We got to do that.
What's your best money management tips?
All right, number one, I say make sure you have a plan for your money. Every cent of you make, have a plan on where it's going to go, where you're gonna put it, and how you're gonna spend it. And number two, and not only have a plan, make sure you stick to the plan, and make sure you have a plan for emergencies, because that's usually what puts us in the hole. Something comes up out of nowhere, we have to end up putting on credit, and they say, you know, we deep in debt.
Money savings tips.
Listen, if you're thinking about it from a couple standpoint, throw all the stuff out the window that you've ever learned. Give the money to the person that can make it work for you all the most. If you're by yourself, get online. It's not that hard to save some money. It's like calories. More money in, less money out.
Surgery questions.
All right, as far as the questions go about my surgery, I have a whole docuseries that's gonna come out. But the short of the long is I recovered very, very well. I was able to keep my ovaries. I don't want no kids. I ain't have no kids. It's over, it's done, and I'm on the road to recovery. Check out that series.
Do you think there will be a time that you'll do a meet and greet with Dre and Shan?
I'm always open for a meet and greet, but here's my thing. It's going to have to be something like I'm going to be in a certain area at a certain time. I
have a couple of more days that I can fill in with some other stuff. Boom, let's do a meet and greet. Charge it to my head, not my heart. I am the type of person that I don't allow what other people want of me to inconvenience me, because I've been burned so many times. When people want you to do something, you change everything, you mix things around, and then boom, they're gone. So I'm very open to it. And as far as meet and greets with Dre and Shan, absolutely. We've talked about that before.
Oh, yes.
Where we're either going to do something where they are, or they're going to come and do something where we are. We can meet in the middle.
Exactly.
Not a problem at all. But the whole thing about that is, we already going to be together having fun, and then we're going to bring y'all along.
Exactly. That's how it's going to work.
Will we host a group cruise with Dre and Shan?
I definitely don't mind a group cruise, but I think the same applies. We just put it out there. And if you just show up, you just show up, because I think if it doesn't work right, it's going to create some unnecessary stress. People going to be upset. People going to be mad and stuff like that. Because even though it's a group cruise, don't mean we're going to always do group projects.
Right.
So we might see y'all once or twice, and we go cut a rug on the dance floor a couple of times. But when you're on vacation, you're out there to spend time with your family or your freaking spouse.
The best and worst thing about YouTube.
I'm going to be honest. I'm a natural introvert. And I'm often comfortable in my bubble. YouTube has opened me up to people that I know without a shadow of a doubt, I would not have met these people in my natural everyday physical life.
Yeah.
There has been people that I can honestly say, you know, you hear it all the time on YouTube. Oh, I've met sisterhood. I've met brotherhood. These are going to be friends for life. You never really know if that's going to be the truth. But I can honestly say, we have met some of the dopest people.
Yes, indeed.
That you probably could ever imagine meeting in your natural life.
Yeah.
So for me, it got me out of my bubble. The negative, the people that come through your channel that maybe watch one video and they know your whole life.
Yeah.
So it's things like that that kind of gets on your nerves, when you have to read them all buckled down and then you go on about your life.
Yeah.
But for the most part, I don't really have a whole lot of negative experiences when it comes to YouTube. How about you?
Yeah, I think you summed it up just perfect.
Do any of your family and friends get mad about what y'all post on your channel?
Yes, we have had a few incidents where some things were published and some family didn't appreciate it, and then we immediately fixed it and immediately apologized. I mean, because the thing about it is, sometimes you can assume that people want to be on camera because
they're all in
the camera, but I don't know. We are very selective now on family that we choose to put in the videos, and if we do, y'all know it's like real quick, you see them and then they're gone. I would love to, because that would be a great dynamic. Because our family is crazy. They will keep you laughing.
Yeah, the lines are very blurred. With us, we've always tried to be mindful.
Yeah.
But that doesn't always work for the other person. So, and of course, no one watches your channel until they watch your channel and see that one video. You know what I'm saying? Now, the way around that is, for me, and I'm willing to take this risk, if you know this is what I do, it's clear of what I'm doing, and you continue to want to be places where you know I am filming, you gonna be in it. I'm just sorry.
What's y'all's best vacation thus far and why?
Oh man, that's one of the easiest questions right there, man. Y'all already know.
Yeah, man.
Jamaica, man. I don't know if there is any vacation that's ever gonna be able to top it. And the reason why, it wasn't only because of the fun we had, it was the experience and the way that they treated us. Y'all know that. They made sure we was good, even though there was some screw-ups. I don't even know what the screw-ups feel like now, because they treated me so well.
They smoothed it over. And it's genuine. Like, some people would be like, oh, of course they're nice to you. You're paying them. No. There's a freaking difference. It was like they met their extended family.
Yes.
The gardeners, the people that are taking care of the lawn, people that aren't directly getting any money directly from you.
Mm-hmm.
These people were just, hey, how you doing? You look great. What's going on? What you planning on doing today? Make sure you eat this. Make sure you check out this. So it was just like you met a part of your family that you didn't know that you met.
Yeah.
It was so dope.
I feel like I was at home.
We were celebrating birthdays with staff members over there.
Yep.
People were watching out for us. Our YouTube family, a couple of them worked at the resort that we were at. So it was just so dope. Not that we needed to be treated like kings and queens to have a good time on vacation, but it feels so good when you have people that's really looking out for you. Not necessarily doing for you, looking out for you.
Exactly.
Making sure you good.
Mm-hmm.
And if you ain't good, What can we do to help this out? Yep. Because we want to make sure that you're good in our country.
When planning a trip in-state, out-of-state, even a different country, what to plan for?
So for me and my husband, when we go on vacation, we have two things in mind. Relaxation and having a good freaking time.
Yeah.
I know the two usually don't coexist, but for us, we're looking for somewhere where we're going to be very comfortable in our downtime. So when we don't feel like being out and about, we have everything we need. We have the infinity pools, the swim up bars, and all the amenities that makes vacation and a vacation. We look for those things. We look for places that are culturally accepting of us. I'm not going somewhere to be treated like crap. And there are certain countries that tolerate you, but you know they don't really want you there. And then once I get tired of being at the resort, what else can I do? Can I go out and meet and mingle with some folk? Can I go out and get some great authentic food? Mm-hmm. Can I hang glide? You know, can I swim with the dolphins or stuff like that? So,
and the stingrays.
Yeah, and the stingrays. I'm supposed to be there right now.
No, I knew it.
No. I'm having a hard time. We're supposed to be on vacation at this very moment. Yeah. On our way to Jamaica and to Mexico.
Dang.
What is your favorite type of vacation or destination?
All inclusive. We this past year we did enjoy the cruise, but we still love the all inclusive resort option still the best because you're more free. There's more stuff to do. There's more stuff to eat. More places to go. You still can do that stuff on a cruise ship as well, but you're more free when you're at a resort, and you won't understand it until you actually
do both.
Yeah, you have to do both,
and both in order place.
To understand. And to me, the amount of money that you spend for a cruise can pay for like two all-inclusive resorts.
And this is another way that I always explain it to people. Me and Shan were having this conversation. With me, with cruising is so corporate. Cruising is making sure that everyone is included, that there isn't anyone that's going to feel a little slighted. When you go to someone's island, they don't really usually give a fuck about what you want because you are immersing yourself into their culture.
You're the guest.
Yeah, so when you go, like for instance, like when we went to Jamaica, I wasn't expecting to hear no go-go in Jamaica. I knew that I was immersing myself into their culture, and that's what I wanted.
Mm-hmm.
And that was the experience that I got. I didn't get the corporate experience where they were trying to mix, mingle, and not step on my toes to make me feel offended by anything so I could write a letter to corporate and tell them I ain't having fun on my cruise. They didn't have my music. Well, God darn it, you knew you wouldn't have any music when you went to their country. All inclusive, you dive into their culture.
Yeah.
A cruise, you have a melting pot.
Yeah. Cookie cutter.
Yeah, it's very cookie cutter. And within that, you can have a great time.
All inclusive all day, but like we said, we will cruise.
Yeah, we'll do both.
Yeah, we was getting ready to. We're supposed to be on it now.
Do you have any hands-on advice for places such as Aruba, Cayman Islands, Barbados, other parts of Jamaica, and possibly Belize? Have you two ever been to Canada?
I don't, but we have the people that do. See, that's the thing about being on YouTube and getting to know people and mix and mingling. Finding the Foresters. We will link their channel down below. They are some real travelers. Like for us, we're just really dipping our little toes.
Yeah, we just got our baby toe in there right now. Yeah.
So we can tell you what we know, but what we don't know, I can tell you where to find the information.
Yeah.
Reach out to Tiffany and Brian and even Bryce, because he young and he don't travel more than I have. And they can tell you everything that you need to know. Just write them a comment. They will get back with you.
Yeah, and tell them we sent you.
Yeah, of course. All right, so you've reached the end of this video. I know we were trying to put everything in one long video, but it's getting too long.
Yeah.
So part two, where we'll have all of the marital talk and all that juicy stuff that y'all really want to know.
We swingers. We thought y'all been picked up on that by now.
You know. It's agreed upon, and that's going to be up on tomorrow. If you're watching this later, we'll just have it linked directly below. All right. Deal. See you tomorrow.
Boom.